Dear students, today we will start chapter 3, Structure of Matter. So what is matter? Everything present around us is matter. Living things are matter, non-living things are matter. So matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. We can sense matter with the help of our sense organs. Like we can see, we can feel, we can hear matter with the help of our sense organs. Matter is made up of very small particles, atoms or molecules. Now, what is atom? Atom is the smallest particle that can take part in chemical reaction. It may or may not exist independently. Molecule is smallest particle that can normally exist independently. Matter may be element, compound or mixture. So what are elements? A substance made up of only one kind of atoms that cannot be broken down into simpler substances by chemical methods is called element. Till now, total 118 elements are known. Out of these, 92 elements are natural. Means these are found in nature. These occur in nature. 26 elements are man-made. These are made in laboratories. Where do these elements occur? Occurrence of elements. Very few elements occur in free state in nature. For example, oxygen, nitrogen, gold, etc. But most of the elements are obtained by breaking up a compound into its constituents, atoms, constituent elements. For example, oxygen and hydrogen can be obtained by electrolysis of water. This means very few elements are in free state, but most of the elements are present in compound form. Two or more elements are joined together which form compounds. Next topic is mixture. When two or more elements or compounds are mixed together and there is no chemical change between them, we get a mixture. For example, if we mix sand and sugar, we get a mixture. If we mix sugar and water, that is mixture. Now, what is difference between compounds and mixture? Because compounds have constituents. Compounds are made up of two or more elements, and mixtures are also made up of two or more constituents. So what is difference between compounds and mixtures? First point is, in case of compounds, constituents are combined together chemically. For example, in water, hydrogen and oxygen are present, and these are joined together chemically. In case of mixtures, constituents are combined together not chemically but physically only. For example, if we add sugar in water, these are mixed physically. We can separate sugar and water from sugar solution. second point, ratio of constituents. In case of compounds, constituents are present in fixed ratio. For example, in water, hydrogen and oxygen are present in 1:8. Hydrogen and oxygen are present in 1:8 in water. Source may be sea water, tap water, distilled water. In all the types of water, hydrogen and oxygen are present in 1:8. But in case of mixtures, there is no such condition. Constituents can be present in any ratio. For example, in water, we can mix sugar in any proportion. If we add 1 teaspoon of sugar, then also it is sugar solution. If we add 2 teaspoons of sugar, then also it is sugar solution. So in case of mixture, constituents can be present in any ratio. Third point, separation of constituents. In case of compounds, constituents can be separated only by chemical methods. For example, hydrogen and oxygen can be separated from water by electrolysis. We cannot separate hydrogen and oxygen from water by any physical method. But in case of mixture, constituents can be separated by physical methods like filtration, sedimentation, distillation, magnetic separation, etc. Fourth point, properties. Compounds have properties different from those of their constituents. For example, water is liquid. It is made of hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen is gas, oxygen is gas, but water is liquid. So, properties of the compound formed are different from its constituents. Secondly, hydrogen can burn. Oxygen also supports burning, but water is used as fire extinguisher. So, properties of compounds are different from its constituents. Now, in case of mixture, properties are same as those of their constituents. If we add sugar in water, water is liquid. Sugar solution is also liquid. Sugar is sweet in taste. Sugar solution is also sweet in taste. Fifth point, energy changes. Often energy is absorbed or released during the formation of compounds. When we form compounds, energy is given out or energy is used. If we add quick lime in water, chemical reaction takes place, new compound is formed, and heat is released. Suppose we take a test tube, in that we take some water. Now we add a pinch of quick lime, that is calcium oxide, and stir that, mix that. Now if we touch the test tube, we can feel that test tube gets warm. So heat is released when the compound is formed, or heat is absorbed when compound is formed. But in case of mixture, no energy is absorbed or released when a mixture is formed.